This is your big boy.
So, Gail, we're going to do a side-by-side comparison between the Egg Row and the La Pavoni Europacola.
Okay. I was thinking the AeroPress. Yeah. Press. Go get your steamed milk from somewhere else. Yeah, right. Okay, Kat, I'll see you later.
So about 18 months ago, we had a little demo model in the store for about a week, and we kind of messed around with it.
A bit of filming. Yeah, we did a video at that time.
But now we have our own model, and Gail has been going crazy on it.
Wow, wow.
So we thought we would do a revisit.
It's a little different model.
Okay.
Yeah, a little bit. Not a lot, just a little bit.
So, well, why don't you go through its story here?
This is the Egg Row. This thing is programmable, I'll tell you, yin-yang. Let's start up here. It's got two bean hoppers, and I believe they hold what, is it 3 or 4 pounds a piece?
They look like a lot.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It just holds a lot. Bypass doser, if you want to use a scoop of coffee. It's got copper boilers, brew unit in there. The brew unit, just like you would see in a super automatic, like a Seiko or that, only bigger.
Okay.
Everything about it's bigger. This is the iSteam. This automatically steams the milk to the right temperature. And if you push this, you're going to get more foam. You push this, it's more hot milk.
Can you program what it does there? Or?
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And hot water over here, dispense.
Mm-hmm.
I'll show you.
Agua caliente.
This slides up and down. You can, the coffee comes out of here, and this is a steamer where you can have a gallon of milk right over here. This, we got the one with the refrigerator.
Okay.
This refrigerates the milk and keeps it, and there's hoses that go into the milk here. You can get another model that does not have the refrigerator, where the hoses just go into a jug that you would have sitting on the countertop.
Okay.
Yep.
So this is sort of the top of the line model of the Rancholio Egg Row.
You can also get this with just the iSteam with no milk, automatic milk capabilities.
So it would just do your coffee and then
do coffee out of here and then you'd steam your milk with the iSteam wand.
Okay.
So, programmability. These are all the different ones that we have that you can program each one of these. What's this heart friendly thing? Now we're into decaf.
That's one cool thing. So in your two hoppers up there, you could put decaf on one side and
absolutely.
So
absolutely.
All the people who have asked that of us, are there any super automatics that I can have two bean hoppers?
There it is.
It's just your friendly little Egg Row.
Yeah, okay, I'm 5'7". Here you go. Right.
You're gonna have to build out a space for this in your kitchen.
Here's your dregs box down here. Mm-hmm. We've been playing with it. The drip tray is plumbed in. It's big though. It drains. It has a drain there.
Nice.
See? Drain. And they just dribbled on the countertop. Yep.
Okay.
Let's see. What else do I need to talk about? I can show some of the programmability. It has a USB port so that you can actually put your own logo or video up there. They put these in a lot of little convenience stores.
They're like, buy a hot dog.
Yeah, exactly. So you can have a hot dog flash across the screen.
Fly.
You can have your corn. You can have your hot dog, your corn dog, your popcorn, your chili. Or, no, your nachos with cheese.
Well, you can go in and, since this is the fancy-dancy one-touch version, you have a lot of stuff you can program as far as the cappuccinos and stuff are concerned.
Let me show you. We're just going to pull up one and we'll show you what you can do with it. So this is the main menu that comes up. This is for cleaning. You get in here, and there's your daily cleanings. There's lots of different cleanings you can do, and you need to do that with this machine, or it gets clogged up, like every machine. Okay. Video. This is where you can put your own video in. Play.
We should shoot one of Gail being like, hello!
There's no audio, just video.
Okay. That's no fun.
Technical menu. I think this is locked. We're not going to be able to get into it unless we put in our password, but we're not going to do that. We're not going to show you the password. And then the manager's menu as well. That's stuff you don't want to get into.
What is that? Do you know, recall what's in the manager's
menu? You know, I've been in there. I don't recall what it was. Okay. I have been into it. I can't remember what it was.
But because this can be put in like a convenience store, you can set this up to actually take money so people can just buy the coffee on this, correct?
Yes, you can. Okay. You can set this up for vending. Yeah.
Okay.
Let me see if I can Don't show this now. I think I remember the password. There. Okay, this is what's in the manager's menu. Product configuration, touchscreen, clock settings, cleaning settings, machine setup, product settings, and counters. So, product configurations. Let's get into that. This is the Americano. Now, if I want to choose something else, I can go like this. Now I can choose all of these, and watch, it'll scroll down.
So only the person with the magic
can change it.
Okay.
Oh, these dry hands. Look at which all the, each one of those that we saw earlier, I can change.
Okay.
Let me get into one.
I don't know how you use your iPhone, Gail.
It actually works great. I don't know why. Okay, cappuccino.
Okay.
So I can change the grams of coffee that are ground. The coffee source, whether it comes out of the right or the left hand.
Mm-hmm.
The impulses is how long it's actually going to run to produce the coffee.
Okay.
In other words, it's going to run 1 second, 2 second, three. Those are impulses. That's what they call them anyway. Pre-infusion, it actually pre-infuses a little bit of water on top of the coffee puck, and then it goes into its brew. Tamping pressure, you can even change that. The milk quantity. You can change that.
What would that do? I mean,
the tamping?
Yeah, like why would you want to do...
It's probably the same as what we do when we do ours.
Slow.
Let's say you're close with the grind.
Let's say you're close with the grind.
You want to give it a little more tamp instead of changing the grind.
I see. I'll
show you in a minute how to change the grind, too.
Okay.
Okay, how much foam you get, all these things. And the price if you were sent up for vending.
Okay, cool.
So every one of those drinks can be programmed in that fashion. Pretty cool, huh?
Mm-hmm. All right. So how do you change the grind and stuff?
Up here. I don't know if you can see this or not. Let's look at this one over here. It's probably easier for you to get at. See that whirl?
Okay.
And then if you turn it backwards, it makes it coarser. And if you rotate it forwards, it makes it finer.
Cool.
And the bean hoppers come off, too. You go like this. And you can take them off with the beans in there. Yay. Show the inside of this. Huge.
You dropped one, Gail.
I heard it.
Shall we do some demonstrations? Have you covered all the specs on this baby?
I believe so.
And this is plumbed in, so that's your water source. You got to have that, yada, yada.
For us, we don't happen to have ours plumbed in. We have a 5-gallon jug down there with a flow jet and a bucket for the drain. You like the bucket?
Mm-hmm.
I emptied the bucket yesterday.
Those buckets get stinky. Okay.
So I'm going to do a double latte. A double shot.
Okay. First up, a double shot. Hit that guy. You've got it preset and everything.
It's all programmed. Yeah, it came programmed. We tweaked them a little bit, but for the most part, we have left them the way they were. You know, I was playing around with this because I know the beans have been sitting in there for a few days, and I made a couple of shots.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the best shots I've had in a long time. It was very sweet.
What does that say about your skill set, Gail?
You got it. Woo! Thanks, Kat. Ta-da-ching!
Ba-dum-ching!
Yep.
I need to have a drummer to do a little rim shot.
We have several drummers in our band of...
Merry crewmates.
Yep. One in particular that's here.
He plays in a funk band. Play that funky music.
He plays a lot of different music, actually.
Oh, yeah.
It's not bad, huh?
Mm-mm.
I think it's pretty darn good. Okay, so now we can show you a latte. How about that?
Okay. So you said there's two variations. There's like a large, a Big Daddy latte, and then a small.
This is a latte, and now over here,
a large.
There's
latte.
A large one.
Okay.
This one puts in more coffee too, and it does a pretty darn good job. I mean, I'm impressed. Nice and hot.
And show the steam coming out.
Yep. Watch this. Is that cool?
Mm-hmm. So we've said
It's a show.
Convenience stores, blah, blah, blah. But we've actually sold a lot of these to offices.
Yeah, we've sold more to
pretty
offices.
Pretty popular for people to have in their, like, a large company's kitchen.
Yep. At any time, if you're getting too much, you can interrupt it right here. You just stop it. Okay? Milk or coffee. Mmm. Hot. Oh, it's good, too. Taste that. It's really hot. That was a double shot of my baby's love.
Mmm.
Isn't that hot?
Yeah. Okay.
So we'll get some milk and do some steaming with the ice steam, too.
Show that guy. Okay.
Oh, I was going to show you. This slides up. This is where all the milk action and the coffee action happens. These things need to be cleaned every now and again so they come out their nozzles. But anyway, cool. It's just another feature this thing has.
Easy to care for.
Yep. Okay. I think I'll do steamed milk.
Oh, really? I was hoping we would see some fluffy cappuccino steam.
I should rethought my position. I hope it doesn't do too much. This is a 32-ounce cup.
Get it going, and you can set what temp you want it to stop at, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, look at that. Nice fun.
Slowly rising.
See right up here? Pan up here for a second.
Oh, okay. It's telling you where it's at.
Yep. And pretty soon if it doesn't stop. What it's 156
is what it was,
and
set
it's going
to
rise a little bit higher. So yeah, so now how do you get this out without making a mess?
You don't. But they did have a thing on the to-do in the manual, Gail. Now you need to clean that.
look at the foam. It was way down here.
Yeah,
did a nice job. It's good foam too.
Can you pour some out, Gail, like in this dude here?
I can.
Maybe we can see.
Yep.
I mean, this is like this is really fluffy cappuccino foam, obviously.
Oh, yeah. This is a spoon. I've spooned it off. That's a lot of foam. You're not going to be able to see it because there's rubber things in the way. I'm sure the level of the milk's way down here.
Is it foam all the way through, basically?
I don't think so. I think it's just like any other. No, I don't think so.
Okay.
I think there's milk down in there. Mmm. Hot milk.
Cool. All right, so that is the Ranchillo Egg Roll.
And the blinking here, I can't remember what that's all about, but...
Change the...
That's appropriate mode. Yeah.
Afterwards, it says do a purge and wipe it down.
Wipe her down.
As usual. Yale.
Here, give me your shirt.
Hey!
I want to wipe her down.
Leave my clothes alone.
I'm not touching your clothes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
So, that's the egg roll, and we're really happy to have it here.
All right, so anything else you want to say about it? It's pretty easy to use once you kind of get it down. But
runs on 220.
220?
Yep, plumb in, drain.
The big thing about this is keep her clean and maintenance, and once you do that, you're pretty set.
The daily maintenance on it is very important. Otherwise, the milk situation gets pretty bad.
Go on. Híjole.
We found out. There was a container of milk in here one day, and I went, oh, my. Why is it got its solids going
extra,
on?
This milk has extra body to it.
who put the thickener in the milk?
Exactly. All right, Ranchillo Egg Roll. Thank you, Gail.
You're welcome.